Quite a ride, huh, Lassie? Huh. You ought to be on board when there's really some action.
I imagine that bar can get pretty rough.
When those big ocean swells hit the mouth of this river, well, it's like trying to navigate in a gigantic washing machine. No one can get out to sea or back in except us. And then sometimes you might wonder about us.
Yeah, it must take a lot of punishment.
Oh, this baby was engineered to ride over breakers, just like a kid in a surfboard.
You ever wipe out?
A few times. But with 16 and a quarter tons of watertight compartments, she'll flip right side up in just a few seconds.
Must be quite an experience.
Yeah, and you get a little wet.
Are those logs part of the same bunch we saw on the ocean side of the bar?
Right.
Beginning to look like that flood washed downriver every log in the state of Oregon. Deposited them all on your doorstep.
The quicker you get them out, the better for us.
I'd sure hate to collide with one of those.
Since the flood, I've hauled in a half a dozen boats that rammed those logs and punctured their hulls.
Well, they told me you got an emergency situation here. I believe them.
Okay, I'll take the wheel.
Thanks for the ride, Chief.
You get rid of those logs, you'll be doing a real service for everyone that has to navigate that bay.
That's what I'm up here for.
Lassie, you come aboard when there's some weather, and we'll shoot the chutes.
She'd like that.
So long.
So long, Chief.
Oh, you beautiful bundle of fur.
Oh. Well, if all the girls had liked me that much, I probably wouldn't have wound up a bachelor.
Jake Peterson.
Nice to see you, sir.
Sir, it's Jake. And you're, Bob Erickson, right?
That's right.
So, you see, I've been keeping track of you. Now, the district ranger's an old friend of mine. We worked together back east for years. He keeps me posted.
Oh, you were in the service?
Yeah, most of my life.
Well, you seem to be doing all right.
You know, I took up forestry when I was a young man because I liked a quiet life.
Well, you certainly picked the wrong profession.
That fact finally dawned on me. So when I retired, I came out here. Bought the JP. Now the race is just between me and the ocean. And whether or not a few Dungeness crabs will honor one of my cages.
Well, it sounds great.
Maybe you'd like to try it. Going to be around a while?
I'm flying north tomorrow morning.
Where are you staying?
In a motel up the road. Say, do you know where there's a good restaurant?
Sure. Right here. You'll be my guest. Fresh crab. All you can eat. I'll take you for a drive. Show you a few things you probably haven't seen yet. And something in particular for you, Lassie. Now, come on, mate. We're needed in the galley. Problem is, Bob, to convince the timber company it's worth their while to get those logs out of the ocean.
I figure it's up to me to see that nobody takes a loss. After all, the flood wasn't anybody's fault.
Had the logs been scaled?
They were about to start when the flood came along.
Now, that means that the Forest Service isn't able to collect its share of the timber sale, hmm?
Of course not. I'm not here to add to what the lumber company has already lost.
But I'm thinking of that 25% of Forest Service revenue that goes back to the local school districts. Those communities depend on that income for educating their kids.
I see what you mean. If I propose that we split expenses and agree to break even on the recovery, the school district could still get its full share.
That's powerful ammunition to bargain with. Nobody loses. The kids profit.
You think the loggers will go for it?
Well, they're leaders in the community. They got kids in school. They'll go along with you. Take my word.
How come they let you retire?
Maybe I do know a little about dealing man to man. But you youngsters have had a kind of training that we old-timers never even dreamed of.
Nevertheless, thanks.
Letting me take Lassie fishing tomorrow.
Fine. I'll pick her up on my way back.
Thank you.
We don't care about her.
Only like the nice big males.
You better watch out for your nose there, Lassie.
Smell it? Bad weather's coming up. We gotta work fast, Lassie. Okay. No place to dawdle, that's for sure.
Thank you. Hi, Lassie. You clobbered me. Into those cliffs. We'll get smashed into a million pieces. We don't want that, do we? This thing out yet.
They're adrift! Almost in that cliff!
Killed, mister.
There's a boat stranded about a mile off the south jetty, drifting into those shore breakers.
Near those cliffs? Okay, I'll drop you off at the station. We'll go out and pick her up.
There's no time. She's heading into that surf now.
Look, to get to the ocean, I have to cross the bar. Right now, it's rough enough to break the back of a full-size freighter. No passengers!
Lassie's on that boat!
The poor weather gear. Get him suited up.
Lassie. What happened?
I rammed a log. Busted the hull. My shoulder. My head. A concussion, I guess. I thought for sure we was heading into the cliffs. You almost did.
One of those logs?
That figures. Lucky I found them. What were you doing up in the chopper?
Flying back from a meeting about those very logs.
And?
As soon as the weather clears, they'll start getting them out. One less hazard for you to worry about. We've been through a lot together, haven't we, Lassie?
You'll be back with your other godfather in a few days.
Maybe life will be a little calmer. Sure gonna miss you, girl. We'll be together again.